Hi Cancers, welcome to October 2018 readings. This is going to be for Cancer, Sun, Moon and Rising. My name is Ayushi and I'm from India. Let's see what's coming up for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising for the month of October 2018. 10 card Celtic Cross. Cancers, messages for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising. Messages for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising. Messages for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising. What are the messages coming in for Cancer, Sun, Moon and Rising for October 2018? So Cancers, two cards came out for you as a flipper. Bottom of the deck right now is Mother of Wands, and two cards here are 10 of Wands and 8 of Cups. So 10 of Wands and 8 of Cups are telling me that there was some burden that you were carrying. There was something that you were tired of doing, something like a responsibility, or doing something that you were doing on your own without inputs from anybody else. Like somebody decided to take all the duties upon themselves while everybody else in the game is not participating. So there is only one person who is doing the work. And now you are deciding to leave this exhaustion, like you're exhausted doing the work alone. So you are leaving the situation because you feel utterly tired, exhausted, and probably you also feel that there is no point in giving so much of your energy in something in which you are the only person trying to achieve the goal. Probably it's your dream or desire, something that has become repetitive, or something that has become redundant and it's not serving any purpose anymore, so you have to drop it. Why am I saying you have to drop it? Because you are deciding that whatever you were seeking, I think some of you were seeking a soulmate union, or you were seeking a mutual reciprocative like sort of relationship, but that is not happening. So you are leaving these 8 of Cups, which has caused you a lot of pain. All these cups are broken. You feel that like you cannot contain your emotions anymore, and now you have to do something about it and leave things behind in search of something better, something beautiful, something which serves you. You could be dealing with a fire sign, Leo. I'm also getting Capricorn. You could be dealing with a Leo, Capricorn or Sagittarius or Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising. This person can be very much focused on themselves. They might not be paying attention to you, or you are trying to now focus on yourself and not pay attention to whoever that you were investing with in. And some of you are, I'm getting that you are leaving something that was old and done for something that you always wanted to do. Like I'm saying, you are working on something now which will serve for something, like, you know, serve you in an enormous way. You have something to start, something to build from the ground zero, because you have new inspiration now. You feel excited and there is some idea that you want to explore. You are leaving out the old and starting something new. Here's the Fool card, starting from the ground zero, the Fool card. So you are going to trust yourself and take that leap of faith. Some of you are definitely dealing with an Aries person or fire sign generally. You could be in a company trying to float a idea or something creative basically, or there can be a person that has grabbed your attention at work, but it's mostly on physical level, nothing emotional right now, and they are wanting to work things out with you. Guys, take the messages that resonate with you and leave the rest, and use your own intuition to make sense of the messages that I'm giving you. Not everything is going to resonate with you because it's a general reading. So what are the messages coming in for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising? I think there was some confusion related to Leo person. Now that confusion has probably cleared out and you have gained some strength in yourself, inner strength and resilience to get over this situation which was confusing you, which was sort of debilitating you, it was throwing you off guard or something like that. And now you are gaining strength within yourself to dispel this confusion that you were having. And you are going to be focused on your work that you have at hand, is what I'm getting here. You are going to get stubborn about something. Yes, this card is coming up again. Because something has left you disappointed and dissatisfied, something that you thought will fulfill you emotionally is not fulfilling you. So you are rejecting something and moving on from it because you feel that you can, you can find something better outside this entire situation. Okay, let's begin with your 10 card Celtic Cross. This is a Eight of Pentacles, which is the heart of the reading. You are doing something of like everyday thing. Like you are doing something that you do every day, or you are going to focus on your everyday activity. When you wake up, how you work, what is your routine. You are focusing on all those things, and you are thinking about doing something constructive with your routine. I'm also getting that you are weaving something like you're weaving a cycle, like something that will be fulfilling in long run, something that is not going to be whack, like something. You're not doing something extraordinary, you're just going to focus on something ordinary in order to achieve something extraordinary. So you are going to get into a rut of doing something daily so that eventually you will have something which is extraordinary. That's what I'm getting. And some of you are dealing with somebody at a workplace, so that is also what I'm getting. Hangman is coming up as your challenge, so I'm getting that some of you are in a place where somebody is trying to not respond to you, or they are trying to make you like they might be trying to ignore you, or you are trying to ignore everybody else. But what I'm getting here is that you are not able to see a entire picture due to somebody being narrow-minded or somebody hiding something. But something is stuck here, like something is stuck in a sense that either you are dealing with a Pisces person who is coming up as a challenge, and they are not revealing something to you. I'll focus on that card later on. Let's see what's there first. So you want clarity. You definitely want clarity, or someone around you who is a air sign like a Libra, Aquarius, Gemini, they want clarity. Somebody is being very professional and strict and stern because they want clarity and they want to speak the truth. They want to know the truth. They do not understand or delve in emotions basically, and they are quite professional in their work. So maybe somebody at work is trying to be very, very professional, and they don't want to listen to other people's ideas, other people's point of view. They just are very narrow-minded and they just want to listen to what they have to say and how they what they want. So they don't concern with what other people are trying to tell them, and that is your challenge. Now, Two of Pentacles in the past is telling me that you were trying to juggle two things, your personal life, professional life, or two people, like some of you are probably juggling between two people, or there is a project at hand and you are trying to multitask as well. So you were trying to balance something in the past, or somebody around you was trying to do this. Three of Wands is your crowning energy. So you want to definitely start something new, and you want to venture out Also, you are waiting for something to come to you, like something you had already invested in, something you had worked upon, and now you want to, basically you're patiently waiting for your results to come in. Nine of Swords in your future. So I think working really hard, waiting for something positive to come in, and somehow I'm getting that something is going to stress you out in future, like it is making you like either you will be working at night and that is why you are stressing out so much, like you are up at night working on some project which is very very important for you, and that is why you are up at night and just torturing yourself and toiling at night, burning the midnight oil, that sort of feeling. Or some of you are just going to overthink about a situation and ruin everything, which is not done. Cancer, don't do that. Like either you are too much focused on your work, or you are just going to obsessively think about something and eventually probably get mad when things, like you are probably aware that your fears can somehow get manifested. So don't fear anything and don't think negative things. So you are in love. Some of you feel that you have found your love partner or your soulmate, or you feel that you deserve to be like you deserve mutual respect and attention and care. So you are realizing that you deserve all those things, and you are probably not going to settle for anything less. So you are looking for this, and you are not settling for anything less. Like I said, somebody at workplace definitely is giving you an idea, or they are showing some, you know, physical attractiveness towards you, and they're expressing things like they find you attractive or something. I'm also getting that there is an opportunity coming your way to explore some idea and put it into action, start something new from beginning, and be dedicated towards it. You will be probably meeting new people to accomplish the goals and desires and dreams that you have. Your fear is that you will be the only person working for the thing that you truly desire. Your fear is that you will not be like you will face a lot of resistance, or your fear is that you want to give it your all, but you feel that you will be ultimately exhausted and there will be a lot of energy that you will have to put in, and probably you are fearing that maybe it, like, what if it all goes to waste. So you are fearing that, or some of you are just hoping that this is the last time that I'm going to put my effort, and after this either it happens or not, I don't care. So you're just trying it for one last time, and you are thinking about this one last time over and over again. So I'm going to invest one more time, just one last time. That's what I'm getting at. Outcome is that you are either dealing with a Pisces, or there is someone like you who is, like, it can be you basically, who is very intuitive, very mysterious, someone who knows a lot, but they're keeping their feelings to themselves. They are not going to express their feeling, or they have some secretive knowledge, so they're planning to keep it to themselves, and they want to just you know, because they know so much, they are just waiting for other people to do their work, and they are just observing quietly what other people are doing and how other people are responding and what are they contributing. So they are just sitting quietly and observing everybody else. You want to stay in control, or you could be dealing with a boss or somebody bossy, someone who is trying to supervise you, or you are trying to take control of the situation and supervise other people, or you are just setting boundaries, because in your heart now you know that what you desire and what you deserve. So you are just setting out boundaries, and you are being very strict with those boundaries, and you are playing like an emperor. So you are not sitting like helplessly, you are actually active, proactive, and you are just out there you know, achieving your things, your dreams, and you're leading. Basically you are leading, you're not somebody who's following, you're leading. So So once you are deciding to put your boundaries, or you are trying to get some strict, you are asking the right questions, you will get, if you will ask the right questions and you will confront the person that you are dealing with, probably you will be victorious and you will be liberated. Probably the truth will be spoken and you will be liberated. So ask the right questions. And whatever that you were trying to juggle, or two people, anyone who was juggling two people, they are leaving that situation because it is exhausting and it's not serving anything. So you are mentally leaving that entire situation for something better. You are, in future, whatever you are obsessing about at night, you are obsessing about somebody to come your way and give you a loving message. So you are basically waiting for somebody to come your way and give you a loving hug or message. But I don't think you should wait for that, and you should probably do it for your own self. Don't wait for anybody else. I think you're falling in love with yourself. This is Nine of Pentacles. So you are falling in love with your own self, or you want to stay independent and explore your options. So you are discovering that you want to, probably some of you just want to, enjoy your singlehood or something. Falling in love with your own self. And then this is getting clarified by this. So whatever idea or opportunity comes your way regarding sexual intimacy, whatever sexual encounter, whatever happens, it's going to put you in a very, like, you will be conflicted and trapped. So I will suggest to be very, very mindful of whom you are indulging with, whom are you giving your time and attention, because this energy is going to make you feel trapped. If you will be very clear about the person, you will ask the right question to this person, like, are they married or are they not, or whatever. So probably this person will tell you the truth, and you will feel liberated by that knowledge, and you will probably not indulge with this person who is probably juggling two people. So that was your reading, Cancer. I hope it was helpful, and if it resonated with you, please drop me a comment. By the way, the bottom of the deck is the Temperance card. So Temperance is about keeping a balance. So do not get blown away or swept away, whatever. Be in balance, be in your power. Okay, otherwise you might lose the sight of the reality. So be in control of your emotions. So Cancer, please drop me a comment if it resonated with you. It will really help me to know if people are benefiting from my readings. Thank you.